up, guys? It's Zach. Welcome back to another video. Today, I'm gonna be bringing you guys a Logic Pro X tutorial and basically be showing you guys how I make a pop song from scratch. This tutorial will be aimed more towards beginners who are just starting in Logic or for people who are just getting started making pop music. So as I'm making this song, I'm gonna be showing you guys how I navigate Logic and basically my creative process of how, you know, I print chords down, sound selection, how I start structuring the song and everything. So yeah, if you're a little more advanced, this might not be the video for you, but please feel free to stick around as you may learn something that you might not already know. As you guys are watching this video, just keep in mind that there is no right way to make music. You kind of just have to approach each situation differently, and every song is different. So with that being said, let's hop right into Logic. All right, guys, so here we are on my computer. Feel free to ignore my cat back there. He's just he's just chilling. But all right, so here we are on my computer. I'm gonna start by opening up Logic. So, all right. So chances are when you open up Logic, you might get this screen popping up or your screen might look a little different. If your screen looks like this, go ahead and say, create new empty project and just hit okay. And you know, this will pop up. But before I jump into that, I'm just gonna cancel that really quick because you guys might get a different screen. If you click on Logic and this screen pops up, just go ahead and hit new project as well and go ahead and click empty project. You can start off with different templates if you'd like. If you go ahead and click project templates, you can get hip hop, electronic, songwriter, all the templates that Logic offers. But for this tutorial, let's just go ahead and start with an empty project just because this is how I start every single one of my songs. Okay, so go ahead and open that up. So here we are, here's the screen again. Depending on what you want to do, you can start by creating an audio track. The audio track is for recording guitars, recording vocals, stuff like that, like anything that isn't MIDI. That's what an audio track is. For this song, however, I am gonna start with MIDI just because I already have a chord progression in mind that I do want to use. So I'm gonna go ahead and start by selecting a software instrument. Here, under instrument, this is where you can select, you know, whatever instruments you want. For example, I'm just gonna open up a stock Logic piano. So I'm gonna go to sampler, hit stereo, and then just hit create. And so here we are, here is the sampler. This is the sampler instrument in Logic itself. You can just go ahead and close that by hitting this X button. All right, so from here, I'm gonna go ahead and hover over this library. This is your library option in Logic. You can open it up by pressing Y on your keyboard as it just showed you. I honestly didn't know that because I just used the mouse. When you're selected on this stock Logic sampler instrument, you can go ahead and click library, hover over to your pianos, and I always either choose a Yamaha piano or a Steinway grand piano. This is just laying down like just laying down raw chords, so it really doesn't matter which piano you choose. I just went ahead and chose the Yamaha grand piano. And so with my MIDI keyboard plugged in, you can already start playing chords. Also, I did forget to mention one thing. If you guys wanna hop over to this Logic menu over here and go ahead and go to preferences and scroll down to advanced, you're gonna wanna make sure you have this checked, enable complete features, because if you don't, if you go ahead and uncheck that, Logic will already look a little different and it will kind of resemble GarageBand more than it will like a professional audio DAW. So just make sure you have that clicked and so you'll be able to follow along this tutorial, because if you don't have that clicked, might be a little hard to follow along. So make sure that's clicked. Right now, I'm gonna go ahead and just record a simple chord progression and just try to start building around it. So this chord progression, I was actually sitting at my piano, not at my MIDI keyboard, but my piano at the other corner of the room. And I was just playing around with chords and I came up with this chord progression. So you can record MIDI a few different ways. you can either hit this record button right here. And as you can see, this is like your metronome right here. If you turn that off, you won't hear the clicks. I prefer to have the clicks while recording stuff, so I always keep that on. Also, this is like your count. So if you just hit record, and you want it to start automatically, you want to unclick this. So if you unclick it, it just starts recording. However, I do like to have a count in. So if you go ahead and click record, gives you four counts, and then comes in. So just a really handy tool. You can also hit record by pressing R on your keyboard. That's the keyboard shortcut that I always use to record MIDI. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and record this chord progression. Okay, kind of messed that up at the end. I might wanna just do that again because I don't really wanna go and edit the MIDI. One second. Okay, so played it perfectly that time. So what I'm gonna do is actually go ahead and edit the MIDI in this take just because this first take I messed up. So I'm gonna go ahead and drag that over here. And you can either open up the piano roll two different ways. You can either get your mouse and double click it and you'll see that the piano roll pops up, or you can just go ahead and press P on your keyboard and you'll see that the piano roll also pops up. So I'm gonna drag this up just to make it a little bit bigger for you guys. And as you guys can see, the notes aren't exactly on the grid. And that's because I'm a human. When I play stuff in, they aren't always on, like, perfectly on beat. Like a computer. A computer is always perfectly on beat, and as humans, we are not always perfectly on beat. So as you can see, it's pretty close, but this line right here would be perfectly on beat, and as you can see, these notes are close, but they're not perfectly on beat. So what you can do to fix this is make sure you're clicked in this piano roll, and then hit Command A, and it'll select all the MIDI notes that you have in this section that you just recorded. You can then come right over here and quantize. So this is how you quantize your notes and your chord progressions to make them perfectly on beat. So if you hit Q, that'll be quantized. However, you don't always want it to quantize to 16th notes, just because this chord progression is not 16th notes. It's more like half notes and whole notes. So to get it perfectly on beat, I might want to choose quarter notes. However, you can see that if you hit quarter notes, Logic will like snap things to not always be perfectly on beat. So sometimes it is better to just hit eighth notes, if not 16th notes. But you just want to make sure that it's perfectly on beat. So I just went ahead and quantized it to 16th notes, and let's see how that sounds. Perfect. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of like stretch this out just to make sure like we can get just a clean take all the way through. Kind of like get it more sustained a little bit. Just gonna highlight and drag these. All right, so now that we have those down, I'm just gonna go ahead and save this project just so in case, you know, the computer crashes, I don't lose everything. Now, Logic does have a really nice save feature where if your project did crash, it most likely will somehow save it in its backup systems. And when you open up Logic again, it'll say, do you want to go ahead and open up the auto-saved version of your last project? Obviously, you wanna hit yes, just because that will be the project that was last opened, and when it crashed, it creates a saved file of that, which is really, really nice. But you don't always want to rely on that. So it is good to save your projects. So in order to save your projects, you can either scroll up to File and go to Save As, or you can just hit Command S on your keyboard and it'll pull up like your file browser here. I always save them in on my hard drive over here, and this is exactly where the file is gonna save. Just go ahead and click save. Bam. So now the file's saved. So now when you hit Command S, it'll just save. Although Logic does automatically save stuff, which is really nice. So now that we have the chords printed down in Logic, basically what I like to do is then play around with tempo and also just start thinking of sound selection, just because this is what this song will be built off of. And so, let's see. Oh, by the way, if you want to know how I zoomed in on it, it's these buttons over here. This is how you zoom in Logic. You can also hit Command and use your arrow keys to zoom in and out of Logic. So now that we have this chord progression printed down, I'm gonna just go ahead and start playing around with tempo and sound selection. What is it? It's at 120. So I'm gonna go ahead and change the tempo. I might change it back to 120, I really don't know. But let's just see what this sounds like at 100. Okay, that sounds really slow. Let's go back to 120. Okay, I really do like 120, maybe 118. Also sounds pretty good. So that will just be kind of just figuring out what sounds better as we go along. But I'm just gonna crank it back up to 120 just to keep it simple. Now it's time for sound selection. So I already know I don't want a piano in the beginning of the song, because right now I'm thinking of how do I want this song to start. And I obviously want it to start with a really interesting sound, but probably with these chords. And so from here, this is when I start opening up Logic synths, also just other, third-party synths to just see what sounds good. So I'm just gonna open up a new track, and how you can do that is just hit this plus button right here, and then you'll see this window again, and Software Instrument, and from here, I'm gonna go ahead and probably open up Alchemy. By the way, if you guys wanna know my favorite synths to use in Logic, I really like using Alchemy. Alchemy is probably my favorite synth in Logic. If I'm not using Alchemy, I'll probably use Sculpture. And maybe Vintage Electric Piano. Although, I think Kontakt is probably better for that. Also, Nexus has some pretty good, like, electric piano sounds. But yeah, those are pretty much the main three that I personally use out of stock Logic instruments. Logic strings, in my opinion, are also pretty good, but I have Kontakt strings now, so the Kontakt strings just always sound better, so I don't really use these anymore. But I do use Alchemy a lot still, so I'm just gonna go ahead and open up Alchemy and just start looking for sound selections. So now that we have this track right here, if you hover over to this window here, this is your inspector window. It's on this tab right here. And we can go ahead and close the library because we don't really need that right now. But if you go ahead and move your mouse over to Alchemy and click this, you'll see that Alchemy opens up. And Alchemy is just a really good synth for like pop music, pretty much anything really. It's a pretty good synth. I really, really like it, and I love that it's free because it comes with Logic. I kind of want to just play around with keys and maybe pads and maybe synth sounds. So I'm just going to go ahead and go straight to keys. I'm going to choose pop because we're making a pop song. And just kind of start playing around with these presets. And now we want to copy the MIDI over to this track. And so what you want to do is just click this MIDI section, move this out of the way. So click this MIDI section, hold Option, and then drag it down, and that will duplicate it. You can also copy it, Command C, and just make sure this track is selected, and then just hit Command V. That's another way to do it as well. But I always just, you know, Option and drag, because that's like the fastest way to do it. So obviously we don't want the piano playing right now, because we just want to hear what the Alchemy synth sounds like. Okay, I didn't really like that sound, so I'm just gonna keep flipping through. Next one. By the way, if you want this playhead to go to the beginning to play it again, instead of hovering your mouse over to it, dragging it, and then coming back over to Alchemy, you know, you can leave your mouse over here and just hit enter on your keyboard, and your playhead will just snap back to the beginning, and that's how you can do it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and loop this, and then we can just start changing sounds. By the way, how you loop stuff is, if you've noticed this yellow bar up here, you can either hit C on your keyboard, and this yellow bar should pop up. You can also click this, these arrows right here. That's the loop button. And if you're not getting this on your screen, just go ahead and get your mouse and just drag, like so. And that's how you will get your loop coming in. And you can just go ahead and line that up with this section. So. Not really feeling it.
Eternity later.
All right, guys, so I am back, and as you can see, there are a lot of tracks now. A lot of them are muted just because they're sounds that I didn't really care for. All these sounds I did find in Alchemy. A lot of them I didn't really like for this particular song, but I did find three sounds that I thought worked really well together, and they sound pretty cool when put together. And this is what they sound like. Whoops. All right, here we go. Come on. All right, so quick tip of the day. If Logic is doing this thing where you keep trying to play it and this message keeps popping up, system overload, the auto engine was unable to process all required data in time, this just means your computer can't keep up with all the tracks and like plugins that you have in your project file. A quick workaround that I have found to prevent this from happening is to actually just come over here. So right click on any track, just right click, and scroll down to track header components and click on slash off. And what this will do is it will allow you to turn off the tracks that you aren't currently using. So as you can see, I'm only using three right now. So that means all the others, there's a total of 24 tracks. So that means all 22 tracks that I'm not using, I can turn off, and therefore they are no longer active. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. You do that by clicking this power button looking thing right here. And if you wanna turn off all of them, you can just click and then drag down. That's one way to do it. Or you can just go ahead and highlight and just click all of them. That's another way to do it. So now, now we only have three tracks that are on. And so now, hopefully that message won't be popping up. Let's go ahead and try this one more time. Sounds pretty cool. And so I'll just go ahead and kind of like show you which sounds I use since they're all in Alchemy. And if you have Logic, you will have Alchemy, which is really cool. So this one right here, it's like a pad sounding thing. And it's the smooth keys preset. The second sound, it's like another pad sound, just deeper. This is called Shimmering Harmonics, and I'm using the Gloomy Gurgling synth. Now, actually, fun fact, when I first clicked Shimmering Harmonics, this is what it sounded like. But I wanted more of like a deep pad sound, so I stumbled upon this preset right here. But as you can hear, it's still like, I didn't want that like 8th note, 16th note, like stabbing sound, like vibrating sound, so I wanted it to just be smooth. And so what I did here was just played around with the shake attack. I believe I just put that up to 100. Yeah, got rid of it. And so that is the second sound that I stumbled upon. And this is the third sound. So my thought process behind that was I wanted something a bit more plucky and stabby, just because the other two sounds are very soft and soothing, and I wanted something that would contrast that but also go really well with those two other sounds. And so that is where I landed on this one. And as you can see, they do play very well together. So that's that. This third sound here, it's actually, where is it? I think it's this one right here. Yeah. So this preset is in Alchemy. It's called Retro Keys. I actually found it, when I first opened it, it sounded like this. But I just played around with these presets and landed on Plucky Retro. And I just tested it out with the pads and it worked. And so that's just kind of the trial and error phase that I was talking about. That's why this part of sound selection can take a while. Now the reason why I went ahead and bounced this MIDI section to an audio file, which is this one. If you listen carefully, the first note that it plays, I don't know why, but it just doesn't sustain it. And I couldn't figure out why it was doing that. And it sustains the other. So if you listen carefully, you'll understand what I mean. So I don't know why it does that. It catches it the second time around, but for whatever reason, the first time, it just doesn't do it. And so in order to fix that, I just went and highlighted this MIDI section here and hit Control B on my keyboard. And what this allows you to do is basically bounce MIDI sections to audio files. And you can go ahead and name it whatever you want. I don't really name my stuff while I'm producing. I probably should, as it will help me kind of like organize my MIDI sections a little bit better. But I don't really ever do that because I'm just flying through the creative process. So the source file, this will be your the section that you're bouncing. You'll understand what I mean in a minute. But you can either leave it, mute it, or delete it. I always leave it just because you never know if you're gonna need to access that MIDI file again. You don't wanna delete it just because, you know, later down the line you're like, oh, I wanna actually edit that MIDI chord again, but you deleted it and you can't access it again. So just, you know, make sure everything's kind of looking and checked like this. You don't really need to pay too much attention to it, but just make sure your menu looks like this. Just hit okay, and Logic will do its thing. It'll bounce it. And as you can see, this is the audio file. But as you can see, you can still hear it in the audio file. So you can hear that, but it does catch it right over here. And so all I did was I just chopped it, I got my mouse, clicked here, dragged right there, put it over here, and then looped it. And how you can loop is you get your mouse, put it right over here on this top right corner over here, and just click and drag, and that is how you can loop. The other way you can do it is just hold option and drag, and you can do that as well, but for this, I always just drag. So yeah, that is how I got this audio file right here. So, like I already showed you guys, these are the three sounds that I chose. So, what I'm gonna do now is just highlight all these three, put my mouse over here, and just drag. And what we're gonna do is just loop this out so that we can start creating sections slash, you know, adding drums, kind of building like an intro, a verse, maybe a pre-chorus, and yeah, this is how we're gonna do that. So I'm just gonna like loop it to about the 25th bar there. Now, honestly, I mean, what you can do is just delete all this stuff that you're not using. But I personally do like to leave it there. So long as everything's turned off. If everything's turned off, normally it doesn't affect your computer too much. But if you do find it affecting your computer and slowing it down when you're making music, you just highlight all that, hit delete, and it will delete it. But I don't like doing that just because, you know, you might actually have some really good ideas in this stuff. Like, oh wait, maybe these three sounds aren't filling out the mix enough. So I'm gonna go back and see if I can find a fourth sound in here that I really liked. And so that's just my method behind it. Yeah, that's just how I do it. But okay, so now that we have this looped out, I think now I'm gonna start actually trying to add some drums. For drums, I know a lot of producers approach drums a different way. I know Logic has a lot of nice drum features, like it's got some loops here. Like if you click this button over here, this is like your loop library in Logic. So these are like all the loops. You can just go ahead and like, I don't know, let's see, instrument, beats, sure, and then just start, you know, drag it in, see what it will sound like. You know, click, drag, drop it in, see what it'll sound like. I don't really think that drum beat fits it, but I mean, this is just one way to do drums. So when it comes to drums, I personally use a third-party company known as Splice, and it's just something that you open up on your desktop. And it has like all my samples that I downloaded from the company, the service they provide online. If you're not familiar with it, it's about $8 a month for 100 samples a month, I think. You can obviously download more samples per month by paying a little bit more. But I personally just use the 100 samples a month plan that they have just because I don't need 100 samples a month. Like I already have a lot. But I just go ahead here and just start like flipping through drum samples. So I'll just go ahead and choose, or I'll just go ahead and come up here, search all splice sounds, type in kick, and these are like all the kick samples that I have. And what I'll do is actually, just let me exit full screen. I'll actually just kind of loop this in the background and just play through kicks. And you just choose the best one that I really like. So for example, look. Because I'm on headphones, you know, I can't really 100% hear what the kick will sound like on speakers, which is why I prefer to produce on studio monitors. this one. Just go ahead and drag it in. Oops. Bam. This one sounds pretty good too. Bam. Oops, that is not what I meant to do. This was a good one. This one sounds really cool. We don't need that full loop in there. We just need the kick. But all right, so now that we have, how many kicks do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 kicks. This is where you just kind of trial and error. You just test them out to see which one fits better. All right, so with these kicks, what I'm gonna do is just make it a 4-on-the-floor beat. So how I'm gonna do that is, actually we don't, let's just go ahead and chop all that. All right, so what I'm gonna do is just highlight all of them, hold option, and just drag and line it up on the beats up here. So you can see this is like 1 to 2, that's one full measure. And if you look at these long lines here, that's like every beat. And there's 4 beats in a measure. So what you wanna do is just line them up with those lines. And that is how you create a 4-on-the-floor beat. So, this will be the first kick up. Nope. So quick side note, I rarely ever use a kick that already has a hat in it just because it really limits your choices with layering the kick with more hi-hats, because it's nice to just have a kick sample, just a standalone kick sample, and then you can layer it with hats further down the line. So just listening to these, I really liked this kick the best. It's just a nice airy kick. I really liked it. So I think this is the kick that I'm gonna go with. Okay, so drag that up. We don't need these, so we can turn all of these off. Okay, so now that we have the kick here, what I'm gonna do is just drag this over to hopefully maybe, here we can just kinda drag that over again. Hold option and then click and drag. Just because, you know, I'm already thinking of an intro section. So I'm thinking, you know, the first 4 bars will be an intro and then we can go straight into the verse. I'm not sure how long the verse will be. Yeah, I'm just thinking about how I'm gonna structure this song already. But let's just go ahead and listen to this. So that is starting to sound somewhat like a groove, which means we have something. So from here, this is where I really start maybe playing around with more percussion samples just to start building the beat. Or if I'm feeling melody inspired, I start putting down more melodies. Right now, I'm feeling more drums, and so I think I'm just gonna start playing around with some more drum samples. I'm probably gonna choose more of like a percussive loop instead of like a kick and drum loop, just because we already have a kick. Go all downloads and probably hit percussion, and then just kind of loop this in the background. I don't know, I really like that. That could be an element further down the line. So I'm just gonna leave that there, put that on mute for now. So a lot of these like percussive like loops here, they might not sound good automatically. That's because they're just out of time. Oops, one second. Let's stop that from playing. A lot of these percussive elements are out of time. So if you see, this is at 110 BPM. This track's at 120. So obviously we do need to time them to the correct BPM of the track. And how I go about doing that is just go ahead and click here. So these are both at 110, which makes it easy. So just go ahead and drop this BPM down to 110. And as you can see, from 5 to 13 is the 8-bar loop. And so you can just drag that back up to 120 and just go ahead and highlight this. And make sure your marker was at the end of that loop. So in my case, it was an 8-bar loop from 5 to 13, so I have it at 13. And once you adjust this back up to 120, you know, it'll be past that line. So then you just wanna hold Option and then click and drag it to that line, and it will snap, and therefore it is timed. Now, if this was at a different BPM, like let's say it was at 90, you drop this back to 90, and then, you know, do the same thing. But since they're both at 110, like I said, it makes it easy for me. And, you know, you can just hold option, click and drag, and it will time it. And then we can kind of test out these with the kick. Not really feeling that one. What does this one sound like? All right, this kind of sounds cool. This might be something. Because it just fits. Just fits in those pockets. And so, I mean, with this, like, this thing here, this could be a snare. You can kind of just put it here. Bam. This is all just trial and error right now. Okay, so what I'm thinking is just kind of have it hit on every four in the verse, and in the chorus, that's when we can have the snare and clap or whatever hit on every 2 and 4. So Because it just really lets that loop, like, groove. And that's just what I thought sounded really good. Okay, so I guess we can just leave those two elements in and just keep on looking for more elements. Honestly, that might be the percussive groove, honestly, right there. Let's look up, I don't know, what snares? Yeah, let's just, like, I don't know, try to find some snares, I guess. I just like this loop, this percussion hit, like, it's not thick enough to fill out that clap or snare that belongs in the verse. And so right now I'm just looking for something to layer that with. And I guess we can just start with snare. Oops. Not that snare. Okay, so this, like, that sounds like a really cool snare fill that I can use somewhere in a transition for the song. So I'm just gonna drag that in and just put that on mute. And I'm gonna come back to that later on down the line when I'm ready for those transitions, just because that actually sounded pretty cool and I thought that fit. Okay. That could be like a chorus snare, not sure yet, but I could layer that in the chorus.
Later.
All right, guys, so after searching for some more snares, claps, and snaps that I can layer with this K-pop percussion sample, I landed on this snap here. And I thought it just sounded really, really cool and would go well with this other sample that's already in the project. So if Logic loads this up, we can then line it up with that sample. Bam, bam. I'm just gonna go ahead and move that right under it so they're together. And let's check out how this sounds. All right, that sounded really, really good. I'm really liking that. That is fire right there. All right, so that is sounding definitely like a pop song. That means I've got something going, which is really, really good. All right, guys, well, I think that's it for this video. If this video does well and you guys want more of this tutorial series, you know, comment down below, let me know, and I'll go ahead and make the second part. And I'll go ahead and dive more into how I'm going to build the verse out and then maybe make the transition to the pre-chorus and then eventually the chorus section. But yeah, if you guys want to see that second part, let me know down below. Smash that like button and I'll go ahead and make a second part. Alright guys, well I hope y'all enjoyed watching this video. I hope y'all are able to learn a lot and I will see you guys in the next one. All right.